All right, let's talk about the 60 Minutes show last night. So, you know, CBS pretends to be a group of journalists, and 60 Minutes pretends to be a group of journalists. And they won't, according to them, they won't touch a story unless they can verify this story internally. But of course, we all know the story with 60 Minutes and how even when they can verify a story and then their corporate lawyers come downstairs and tell them to not do the story, they just, you know, just ignore certain stories. Like, talk to Lowell Bergman, of course, who used to work at 60 Minutes when he was taking on Big Tobacco and that famous story, which was turned into an amazing Michael Mann movie starring, what's his name? Russell Crowe, who played Jeffrey Wigand, taking on the Big Tobacco in 60 Minutes. Basically, their overlords basically said, don't do this, don't do the story, because we don't want to get sued. We don't want to get sued. And run by billionaires, by the way. Of course, one of them who just passed away just recently, Summer Redstone. But, you know, that CEO ship right now is vacant. I guess his wife is kind of running the show until they fill the ship over there at CBS Viacom. But the mainstream media is going to spend their mornings. I was watching some of the other morning talk shows this morning. They're all spending their time talking about Trump storming out of the interview with Leslie Stahl. So, yes, we can show you some of that if we want to, but I really don't want to because everyone else is doing that, and that's what the mainstream media will do. No, there was a far more interesting interview last night, though, on 60 Minutes, and it was with Kamala Harris. And, you know, Nora O'Donnell basically going after her using right-wing talking points, framing everything almost as if the Trump campaign had written her questions for her last night. That you're a progressive, you're the most liberal senator in the United States Senate. How does it feel to be so liberal? Are you a socialist? Well, it's not true at all. But so asking her these questions about how she would vote, will she try to change Joe Biden in any kind of way? Will she try to push him more left? Or is she going to try to go more towards the center like Joe Biden? So let me play a little bit of this because I think this is incredibly revealing. First of all, about the state of the media. I was infuriated watching this whole interview that you couldn't have this sort of independent journalist coming up with her own questions. It's almost as if someone wrote them for her, these kind of talking points. And then to watch Kamala Harris basically run away from the very policies that, in fact, arguably are some of the most popular policies in the country that could help the American people on climate change, to affordable to health care for all, Medicare for all. No. Running the opposite direction, laughing it off as if it's some big joke. Wasn't a joke, though, when you were out there talking about universal basic income during the pandemic and also health care for all and supporting a Green New Deal. Your boss, Joe Biden, doesn't support that. I'm just going to laugh it off. So here's a little bit of this back and forth last night between Nora O'Donnell pretending to be, an independent, clear-eyed journalist over there working for the billionaires at CBS. And by the way, they'll probably try to take this video down. There's been a lot of that going around lately, trying to, you know, they don't like us talking about these types of things. So they end up killing off videos. They end up taking you down. But we're going to continue to do these stories. And I've already had a couple of videos that have been blocked. They don't want to share in the truth here. It's true. In fact, I'll jump in later in the afternoon and see that one of my videos has been blocked. Corporate media. CBS has tried to stop me from doing another video before. Truth. So we'll see if they block this one. At least you're live. You get to see it live. So here was 60 Minutes last night with Nora O'Donnell interviewing Kamala Harris. And just watch this.
You're very different in the policies that you've supported in the past. You're considered the most liberal United States senator.
Somebody said that, and it actually was Mike Pence on the debate stage. But
yeah. Well, actually, the nonpartisan GovTrack has rated you as the most liberal senator. You supported the Green New Deal. You supported Medicare for all. You've supported legalizing marijuana. Joe Biden doesn't support those things.
So you're getting your talking point. It's like right wingers basically wrote these talks. You're more lefty than Bernie Sanders. She's to the left of AOC. Really? She's more left than Bernie Sanders. I mean, this is exactly out of the Trump playbook right now. This is why he's losing the election, by the way. Because he thought this line of attack would work and people can see right through it. You're the most liberal. You're like a socialist. How do you even get up in the morning? You're like a socialist. It's not true at all.
So are you going to bring the policies, those progressive policies that you supported as senator, into a Biden administration?
What I will do, and I promise you this, and this is what Joe wants me to do, this was part of our deal. I will always share with him my lived experience as it relates to any issue that we confront. And I promised Joe that I will give him that perspective and always be honest with him.
And is that a socialist or progressive perspective?
What? And I love how she, like, okay, you know, I work for a $1 billion corporation here at CBS News. I know who pays my bills. Are you a socialist? I mean, it's like one step away from saying, calling someone like a Satanist or something. Are you a socialist? Are you a socialist? Look at her face.
Oh.
No. No, I'm not a socialist. That's terrible. This laugh, I mean, it's unbelievable.
No, it is the
progressive perspective.
No.
Oh, no.
No, it is the perspective of a woman who grew up a black child in America, who was also a prosecutor, who also has a mother who arrived here at the age of 19 from India, who also...
Let me just go back to my talking points out on the campaign trail. I am the mother of a person who... Come on. Listen to her voice stammering. Is that a socialist person? No, I got to distance myself from that as far away as I could. You know, as far as going to run as far away as I can. I'm going to run as far away from what this country actually needs that could actually help people. I'm just going to run as far away as I can so we can get elected. I'm going to show you in a minute how excited Wall Street is about a Biden-Harris presidency right now. Make no mistake about how nothing, you know, make no mistake, nothing's going to change in this country. As these guys get into office, bought and sold by these big donors. Socialist, are you kidding me? I'm not a socialist.
You know, likes hip hop, who, perspective of a woman.
Aggressive perspective?
No.
No, I'm not a progressive. Well, she should have answered it. I mean, first of all, could she have looked at Nora O'Donnell and says, you know, you look angry. You look angry when you ask me if I'm a progressive, that I'm a progressive socialist. Yeah. If you want to go down the line on these policies where 60 to 70% of Americans support each of these types of policies. Yeah. Clean air, clean water. To end fracking. Yeah. Healthcare for all, Medicare for all. All of these things. You're just laughing about it. Are you a socialist? Are you a progressive? I can't get over her face the way she asks this question.
And I promised Joe that I will give him that perspective and always be honest with him.
And is that a socialist or progressive perspective?
Is that a socialist or progressive perspective? My bosses are making sure that I ask this question. We're independent journalists here at 60 Minutes. We pretend like we don't have corporate overlords. We just want to make sure here at CBS that you're not going to do something radical. You know, like you know, like help the environment or pass Medicare for all or things that could help the American people. I just want to make sure that that's what you're not going to do. But she answers the question. Oh, I'm going to go back to my political talking points, my campaign talking points right now. I'm going to get you off of this socialist thing. I am not a socialist. No, I'm not. I am not a socialist. I'm just a girl that grew up listening to hip hop. You know, that's who I am.
No. No, it is the perspective of a woman who grew up a black child in America, who was also a prosecutor, who also has a mother who arrived here at the age of 19 from India, who also, you know, likes hip hop. Like, what do you want to know?
Well, I want to give you the opportunity to address this because.
What do you want to know? I got to run away from this. What do you want to know? I'm just a girl who likes hip hop. I'll move with it. However, the weather vane, I'll be your weather vane. So if the wind blows this way, I'll just blow that way. It's politically convenient for me to support the Green New Deal. I'll do that, Nora. Is that what you want me to say? Look, folks, I believe you're looking at the next president of the United States right here. That's why I'm talking about this. Kamala Harris is going to become essentially the next president of the United States. And, you know, my little girl, my 8-year-old little girl, we like to joke after the debate the other night, she'll go, I'm speaking. Like she'll do the Kamala Harris when her brother interrupts her. I'm speaking. You know, we love, in our family, we like strong women. And so we showed her those clips. See, this is how when someone wants to interrupt you as a woman, you stand up for yourself as a woman. I'm speaking, Mr. Vice President. I'm speaking. So yes, we like her to have that strong spine to stand up to President Trump. But also, we want that spine to be strong to stand up to corporate interests and to stand up for the things that really matter in America right now. Universal health care for all during a pandemic. A Green New Deal that's you know, not some big buyout for billionaires in the green space, but an actual Green New Deal that could transform our economy away from a reliance on fossil fuels and away from fracking and away from, you know, high amounts of carbon emissions where we only have literally a few years left before we hit that point of no return. Fact. Someone who has a strong spine who's not going to just blow with the wind. So the sort of laughing it off, I'm running away from this. Oh, I might have supported this stuff before, but now, you know, Joe, I'm with Joe. If we want you to be a strong, independent woman who is tough and it can stand up to these people, can stand up to corruption, great. Or are you just a weather vane blowing in the wind? You know, what do you want me to say here? I'll say whatever you want me to say. I'm just going to laugh about it. I don't know. Do you want me to be a socialist today? Is that bad?
What do you want to know?
Well, I want to give you the opportunity to address this because at the Republican National Convention, yeah. President Trump made the case that Joe Biden is going to be nothing more than a Trojan horse for socialist policies, for the left wing of the Democratic Party.
What idiot believes that? What idiot believes that? This has been Trump's talking point and why he's losing the election. He went all in on this idea that his only line of attack, and it's not worked. In fact, it's made him more popular in polls because Trump has called him a socialist. Because Trump has said, yeah, you're going to vote for this Biden guy? He wants universal health care for everybody. You're going to vote for him? I know it's a pandemic and no one has health care. You're going to vote for a guy that wants to give you health care? You want a guy that's going to end fracking? Then vote for Biden. Guess what? Turns out people do want health care. They want fracking to end. But see, these guys, these corporate elites, these corporate Democrats, these limo-driving corporate Democrats, the limo liberals, as my friend likes to say, And these corporate Republicans, like the Mitch McConnells of the world, who are all bought and sold by these big energy companies, they're not going to change anything. They're not going to change anything. And again, this whole line of attack from President Trump has not worked. If anything, it's helped Biden by calling him some sort of a radical socialist. He's not. Here's a guy who literally has made billions of dollars or millions of dollars from Wall Street. Well, and I'm going to show you in a second just how happy Wall Street is with the Biden presidency. He supported the crime bill. He's voted to expand our wars from 2 wars to 7 wars. He, along with Barack Obama, deported more immigrants in America than President Trump has by a landslide. It's not even close. So Joe Biden's a radical socialist? Who believes that? So Nora O'Donnell, they're parroting these right-wing talking points? She knows that that's not true. So why is she even saying it? It's laughable.
Are you going to push those policies when you're vice president of the United States?
I am not going to be confined to Donald Trump's definition of who I or anybody else is. And I think America has learned that that would be a mistake.
So just to button that up, because you have fought for Medicare for all. That's not something that Joe Biden supports. If you become vice president, would you say to a President Biden, you know what? We should really be pushing for Medicare for all, not a public option. That's just not going to do it. That's not my value.
I would not have joined the ticket if I didn't support what Joe was proposing. And so our plan includes expanding on everything that Joe, together with President Obama, created with the Affordable Care Act. By contrast, you have Donald Trump, who's in court right now trying to get rid of a policy that brought health care to over 20 million people, including protecting people with pre-existing conditions, and he's doing it in the middle of a pandemic that has killed over 215,000 Americans.
So back to the talking points. Here's your next president of the United States. You can see just the wheels turning in the head. Okay, what do I say? What do I say so I don't get in trouble with our donors? What do I say so I don't get in trouble with Joe? You know, if I was really independent and I wasn't bought and sold by all of these big donors, all of these Hollywood donors, all of these Wall Street donors, what would I say? What could I say? I would say, yes, I want Medicare for all. And by the way, it's overwhelmingly supported by the American people. So here I am on 60 Minutes being watched by millions of people. Yes, I want Medicare for all. Not only would they win in a landslide election victory, but they would actually afford the type of change that we need in this country. Medicare for all. So I love this interview last night. I just was cringing the whole time, both at the way that Nora O'Donnell was asking the questions, like all of these right-wing framed talking points, right? So she's taking something that's not true. You know, Republicans say that you're going to move this country, that, you know, Joe Biden is a socialist, he's a leftist, that your country is going to move in that direction. What do you say to the American people? First of all, do you even believe that, that you're even saying that? That's a pile of horse crap, number one. Number two, yeah, what if I am? So let me get this straight. You want me to go against providing universal health care for everybody? Nora? Just let that sink in for a minute on her. Stew on that for a little bit. So Nora, I just want to be clear about something. With those evil eyes, you don't think having universal health care for all Americans right now in a pandemic would make sense? Joe Biden won't come out and say it. Maybe Kamala will. And maybe it's encouraging, I don't know, that in fact she has supported some of these things in the past, because Joe Biden's not going to do anything about it. Again, the reason I did it is because the reason I'm so struck by this, she is going to be the next president of the United States. I mean, if you saw the interview that Biden did last night, I mean, if you can watch this where he can't remember who the president of the United States is, He was on 60 Minutes last night. You can't remember who the president of the United States is right now. It's almost like Jill has to lean over and tell him who. No, it's not him. It's Trump. It's not George W. Bush anymore. This is frightening.
This is the most consequential, not because I'm running, but because who I'm running against. This is the most consequential election in a long, long, long time. And the character of the country, in my view, is literally on the ballot. What kind of country we're going to be. Four more years of Georgia, he's going to find ourselves in a position where.
Yeah, we don't want four more years of George W. Bush. Certainly don't. I don't want four more years of George W. Bush. Do you? When will George W. Bush, you know, can we vote George W. Bush out of office?
What kind of country we're going to be. Four more years of Georgia, he's going to find ourselves in a position where if Trump gets elected, we're going to be in a different world.
Yeah, a different world. I don't want four more years of George W. Bush. Do you? So Trump took to Twitter last night to mock him for his interview. Couldn't remember who the president of the United States is. Of course, social media was blowing up with Trump walking out of that 60 Minutes interview when the questions got a little too tough for him to handle. President Obama attacked him, made fun of him for walking out of that interview. While everyone's talking about that, they're missing, I think, the real interview, which was the Kamala Harris interview. And if you are hoping to see a move towards any kind of a progressive agenda in this country, where we have perhaps a universal basic income, Medicare for all, climate change, climate change being affected and on the ballot, worker protections. No, none of that. I'm just going to laugh about it. I'm just a girl who loves hip hop. What do you want? You want me to, what do you expect me to do, Nora? Just whatever you say, just tell me what you want and I'll be it. Okay. So upsetting. So upsetting. I had a friend the other day said, who works on political campaigns. He said, do you ever see the movie Weekend at Bernie's? Yeah, that's Joe Biden. They're like propping this guy up right now. All of that corporate money flooding into the Democrats in August. Record-breaking amounts of money coming into the Biden campaign. Flooding in from Wall Street, which we'll show you in a minute. It's like this. He's like a prop right now. It's like carrying around this guy. You know, you might support him. That's great. You think that there's going to be some big change, then you're lying to yourself. You're absolutely lying to yourself. You want to get this nut job out of the White House? Great. I do too. Make no mistake about that. But this is what we have. This is what we had to choose from. These political weather vanes who just blow around with whatever direction you want them to go. What do you want me to be, Nora? What do you want me to be? I'll be whatever you want me to be. You want me to be just a little girl who loves hip hop?
Grew up a black child in America who was also a prosecutor, who also has a mother who arrived here at the age of 19 from India, who also, you know, likes hip hop. what do you want to know?
Well, I want to give you.
Yeah, what do you want me to be today? What do you want me to be? I'll be whatever you need me to be. If you're new here, subscribe to our channel. Smash that like button. Don't forget you can subscribe to our daily morning newsletter. Deliver it to your inbox first thing in the morning. Just go to morninginvest.com is how you do that. Deliver to your inbox first thing in the morning.